All right. God has surprised every one of us in this 2020. He has been a good God. I think it's worth it to still worship him for another 1 minute. So go ahead, you can take your own song, worship him wherever you are. God is so good, he's so wonderful.
You are good.
You are so good. All right. I want to let you know that the God of heaven that has been with you from the beginning of this year is going to complete it with you in the mighty name of Jesus. Mo fe ko fi okan bale gbo mi laaro yi daada. Mo fe ko fi gbogbo emi re ba mi lo laaro yi daada. O mo die. Olorun fe se awon nkan ko se mani ninu aye ori kokan wa. Things that you cannot but have in your life. And what we are talking about this morning is two extremes. Ikameji, tojina siara won. We are talking about two things that are far away from each other. The topic this morning is ending and beginning. Ending and beginning. Intentionally, I didn't say beginning and the ending. I want you to follow it this morning. Ending and beginning. Listen to me. Where can you go, me dada sa? Ipari ati bere. Nkan meji yi won le pade laye gbo mi sa. Ijo ti a bi o si aye ati ijo to ma jade laye ojo meji yo le pade. But I pray for you. I decree the mighty name of Jesus. Whether it's beginning or ending, all your efforts in life, every endeavors of yours in life, we amount to success in the name of Jesus. Eyan kan gbo mi boya ibera bi pari esa. This is what determines life. This is the passage of life. That's why you need to invite everybody now, because I'm starting the teaching very shortly now. Gbogbo eyan ni ko pe wole boya ibere ni abi pari nkan meji yo de le pade ibera ti pari o pa won pade ara won. Ah, hallelujah. O gbo nkan ti mo so, you hear what I say? The day you entered into this world and the day you will take your exit, those 2 days can never meet. It's impossible. Esa, those days cannot meet. But I say to you, mo gbadura boya ibera bi pari gbogbo idawole ire ajo aye oruko Jesu ase onu bale o ma jasi re fun eni o se ami o type ami wole. Ending and beginning, these two phenomena, these two words, these two factors, they are so important that the sons and daughters of men have not been able to comprehend them. They've not been able to understand them. The pedestrian upon which these two words they exist is so crucial, to the extent that this is what dictates actually your life. I will show this thing to you this morning. If I let me pray for you so that we can just go into history. I man, y'all, we're still going to worship God. We're still going to praise God. Because you know why? It's the last Sunday in the year 2020. So once again, on behalf of myself from my office here, on behalf of every one of us at Gorem Gospel Response Ministry, I want to welcome you to this page, Gospel Response Ministries page. I want to welcome you to church online. I tell you the truth. It's not a mistake that you are here this morning. You are here to have an encounter. And that encounter you will get in the name of Jesus. Let me pray with you quickly. And then we go into what the Lord has for us this morning. Father, we want to say a big thank you. We say a very, very big thank you. Thank you for January to December. Unfortunately for us, through your grace and your power, you have made us to see another Sunday. The very last Sunday in the year 2020, we glorify your name. kise mi mo se kisi se agbara yin o dida ti o da wa si lo ni o agbara wa ko. It's not by our power, it's not by our man, and we acknowledge this. By virtue of this acknowledgement, Father, we render to you praise and worship. We render to you, oh God, adoration. Lord, let your name be glorified. Accept our worship. Accept our praises. Father, we thank you. We commit ourselves to you. Even on this last Sunday, on this Church Online program, as we share the undiluted word of God, we ask the Holy Spirit will take control. Let your power take control. Excellent Spirit, fill us to the brim. Unleash heaven's power, the enablement of God, that which only God can do. Let it have access to us. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty, mighty name, we pray. As we open the pages of the scripture, let your word penetrate our lives with power, with anointing. Let the blessings of the ending be our portion. Let it be ours. Let it come upon us. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty, mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Amen. I want to quickly encourage you. We are on YouTube. Kunle Omoshe here on YouTube. You can get to YouTube and subscribe to our channel on YouTube. You can follow us on Twitter. Kunle Omoshe. You can follow us on Instagram. Kunle Omoshe. You can follow us on Facebook. Kunle Omoshe. But I want to encourage you, always come to the ministry's page to avail yourself of programs, avail yourself of words, of materials that can benefit your life, that can bless your life. All right? Always come on this page. Even when we are not doing live broadcasts like this, come on this page and you will see materials that can be of benefit to your life, to your business, to your family, to everything about you. Hallelujah. Because we bring the word of life. Amen. Okay. Ending and beginning. These are two. Ezra, I want everybody to be ready this morning so that you can help us to type in the Bible verses. Give me that answer. Oro meji yi ipari ati ibere. Most of them only want to keep it. They don't get to meet. Despite that, they have dictated your life up to now. Oh my, yeah, you will understand it this morning. And that is why you must grab this word. You must come to understanding. You must make sure you understand this phenomenon that cannot meet, but that has influence upon your life. Ending and beginning. Let me quickly show you. Let me lay the foundation. And these two things are so important to the extent that God gave them express permission. You know why? Because the Almighty God Himself is Alpha and Omega. Kaya ya ya. Maso toli daya. Olorun aye raye gangan ni Alpha ati Omega. Ibere ati opin. Meanwhile, these are phenomena that will determine your life and purpose and destiny. They have influence over the journey of life. And men and women have not come to terms, to understanding, to put themselves on the pedestrian wherein they will be able to understand the spectrum of this world, because there is no dichotomy in between them. It's a growth, beginning and the ending. Hallelujah. But consciously, today's topic is not beginning and the ending, but ending and beginning. And you will know why, even as we proceed. Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 8. That's ECC. Just say Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 8. Ecclesiastes chapter 7 and verse number 8. We will read quite some scriptures today, because I want your life. Listen, the purpose of today's program, let me tell you, so that you will get ready. You are not going to have any wasted day again in life. Malebo so taligaya. Bami dadasha. Koni si ojo kan laye mo to ma je ojo ipadanu fun e loruko Jesu. Ase mo fi soro yen jade sa. Ase ipe, the authority of the call of God. There will not be a wasted day, a wasted week, a wasted month, or wasted years in your life again. As much as the Lord lives, listen, no matter how long you stay on earth, you will have no more. Starting from today, by understanding, you will no longer have wasted years. You will no longer have wasted hours, no wasted minute. Amen. And I tell you the truth, this will come through the word of God this morning by understanding. Mo fe ki gbogun eyan fi okan ba mi lo nile loko laro yi fi okan ba oro yi lo ko le ni tumo ninu irin ajo aye fun o. Many of us we've wasted 10 years. Some have wasted 20 years. Some are 70 years now. And do you know what they realize? They know in the depth of their heart that they've wasted 45 years out of the 70. Some wasted 50. Do you know the shock of it? There are people that are 40 years on earth now. And the only thing they can say is that it's a total waste. 40 years wasted. Not a year of productivity. Not a year that can be reckoned with for life. Kaliba Suntaligaya. Eja baro, you know, Ecclesiastes, any continue, Kosibe, chapter 7, I will read verse 8. Ecclesiastes, chapter 7, and verse 8. Listen to the word of God this morning. Ending and the beginning. I want to see even the spectrum, the idea of God. What happens in the spirit realm? What happens in the throne room of God concerning these two things? In kamiji ti o le pade, wo ko to wa pa ni yara agbara Olorun kalibaya. Hey, Ecclesiastes chapter 7. I will read verse 8 to us now. Better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof. Se yan kan gboro yen sa. Opin kan o sanju ipile sere lo. I'm trying to show you by laying a foundation what goes on in the celestial, in the spirit realm, in the terrestrial world. What goes on behind the scene about these two parallels that never met. In kameji ti o pade ibere ati opin, opin ati ibere. The Bible says better, this is God's word, is the end of a thing. Can I quickly, by virtue of this sentence, tori oro kata koko kai, se eyan kan wa to fe gba oro, aso tele ori afefe yi. Aye fe aye ko, igbeyin odun yi fun e, yo da loruko Jesu. News got to me recently, you know what I mean, just, you see, yesterday, a few hours, I mean, late night yesterday, concerning even one of our movie producers, great and genius, you know, stars that pass on the early hours of Christmas. 25th, I don't know, crazy messy, early hours of 25th of December, the guy passed on. May so rest in peace. Listen to me. You are opportune to still be here listening to me this morning or watching the catch up of this video. Show me, Bobby, sir. Mi o ti bere lori oro ti mo ka jade yi mo so aso tele sinu aye eyan kan to ngbo mi bibeli wi pe opin gbogbo nkan o ma san ju ibere lo. The year 2020 o ikun die o, I pronounce authority by prophetic utterance, the end thereof for this year for you shall be glorious and shall be better in the name of Jesus. And that will be for me too. Because any Oshodoti man bafu onika. That also is for me in the name of Jesus. Listen to me attentively. God make us to quickly understand a systematic view that the envy is always a better thing. It's always better. It has to just be better. That is to say, no matter how wonderful the beginning has been for you, the end has to be better. Aye, what a sweet thing. But do you know what the same God said? I thought these are two phenomena. Let me show you another thing. Isaiah chapter 46 and verse 10. I want us to open the scripture and write the scripture in. Isaiah chapter number 46 and verse 10. Isaiah 46. Mi o ti lo si bita lo laro yo o ta fe si laro ni pe mo fe fun e ni nkan meji to pon dandan fun e lati ma fi bere ati lati ma fi pare. What I want to give you this morning is two things that compulsorily that will help to align your life, two things that you will need to always start the beginning and conclude the ending. But before I show you those two things, I'm trying to show you these two parallel lines, these two things that don't merge. What goes on in the heavenlies about them? All right, let's read Isaiah 46 and verse 10. Oh, thank you, my Father. Isaiah chapter 46 and verse number 10. This is God talking here through the mouth of his prophet, declaring the end from the beginning. Ending, you know, Ecclesiastes, ending is always better than the beginning. The Bible says in Isaiah 46 verse 10, God declares the end of a thing from the beginning. And from ancient times, the things that are not yet done. He declares the ending from the... Can you see the power of the beginning and the atmospheric condition of ending? Ending is better than beginning. But the Bible says God determines this end. He doesn't determine it from the middle. Esa, ibere l'Olorun ti ma pinu bi opin se ma ri. Ye. Why rusan daya kauri daya talia? Eyan kan bi mi gba kan sa. Oni pastor mi o mo bi ti mo ti si. Esa ibere lo ti si. The guy was thinking that is in the course of the journey. Oh my God. Do I am nothing move nothing me o roti? I remember, I don't remember. No sir. Heaven determines the ending from the beginning. And the ending is always better than the beginning. Ipari man da ju ibere. Ibere la te man se ipinu bi ipari se ma ri. Ki lo sele ni ibere? E je ke yan kan se sare tudu pe Olorun. Mo fe ko yin Olorun bi to wa kan ma jo. Oro kan bo jade le. Lord, I worship you. Blessed be your name. Moso aso tele latori afefe laaro yi. From this broadcast, this church online, I prophesy. Eyin tele lo si ibere. Gbogbo ibere to ni lo atunse. Ki pari ko le suwon. Gbogbo aba mi tun ibere na se. Repair those beginnings. Repair those beginnings so that the ending can be glorious. Masunda yeke teribaya. Makuria da yanda sili kavalia. Thank you, our Father. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Moveke yan kan fi okan baro yi lo leni. I want somebody to intentionally follow me today. I have a reason for it. We are going somewhere together. Brothers and sisters, hear me clearly. God determines, move call your sick, let me repeat here. He determines the end from the beginning, not from the middle. And he says, the ending is always better than the beginning. Ipari ma san, wo gbo mi sir, ipari re ma san se. End ye ma da, your end will be good. I say your end will be good. Your end, you want mo ba soro. My end and your end will be glorious. Agbara kagba to n ba rin reja. Ti o fe ki ipari ko da, mo koju ja sagba na. Today be the last Sunday of the month of December. The very last Sunday in the year 2020. I decree concerning you, your ending will be glorious. Your ending will be fantastic. In the name of Jesus. Emikemi agbara kagba ti o fe ki ipari re o da. Ti o fe kodun in ko pari pelu ayo fun e. Leni emi Olorun o koju ja si wo si pe won mi. O bori won fun e. Amen. Now listen to me. Heaven explain to you the atmosphere about this beginning and this ending. Listen to this. Do you know that one? I'm going to show you those two things. One major thing you need to always do. Always. Psalm 92, verse 1 and 2. Let me read it to you. Psalm 92, verse 1 and 2. Psalm 92, verse 1 and 2. I told you it's going to be a deep one this morning. Oh my goodness. Psalm 92. I'm going to read to you verse 1 and verse 2. It is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord. It is a good thing To do what? To give thanks unto the Lord. And to sing praises. Even unto the name of our God. Verse 2. To show forth your loving kindness. That's where I'm going. Your loving kindness in the morning. And your faithfulness every night. Lati ma fi iseun ife ran li owuro ojo ati otito re ni asale in the morning and in the night. Can somebody follow me with the whole of his or her heart this morning? Before I show you those two things that are important for the beginning and the end, Bobby sir, most of you pe ibere ati ash ibere ati opin won le pade, they can never meet. I'm speaking to you prophetically this morning. The beginning and the ending cannot meet. That's why Timothy so fe le kan wi pe ojo to wa si aye esa ati ojo to ma jade laye ojo ti mo wa si aye October 20 ati ojo ti mo ma jade laye. That those particular 2 days, sir, won le pade laye. They cannot meet. The beginning and the ending cannot meet. And the Bible says in Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 8. Ninu we iwa oni wa sori keji ese kejo. Oni ipari, the ending will always be better than the beginning. Eni kan pari odun yi eniyan oku sa. I want to love me of you. Those that have passed away, I'm not. We are not making jest of them. Listen to me. You are finishing this year, but is it better? Is it sweeter? Is it more glorious? Ah, change your country. You understand me? And the Bible, God bless you. I rob by the yabo. Comfort. Akinele, God bless you, man. God bless you, Ribu. Ojulowo makale. Hallelujah. Thank you for joining us. Listen, the Bible says the beginning is better than the ending is better than the beginning. And you are ending this year. Kilo leti o se wa better. Why is it not more glorious? Why is it not sweeter? And I told you, these are 2 things that do not mean. But the Bible says in Isaiah 46 verse 10. Isaiah chapter 46 verse 10. The Almighty God determines the ending. Sori parita soy. To godo daju bere yen. Olorun lo man determine. Ibere lo de ti man determine. Esa, you might leave America and go to Canada, go to UK, go to South Africa, go to Jamaica, journey all over the world. Your ending is determined from your beginning. Ibere ni Olorun ti man mo ipari. Cabo Santalia. Bible says God declares the end from the beginning. Kilo wa shele ti odun yen pari abi o ti ri pe iwo gan tin wa ni end the year ti. Maybe you are 80, 90, 100, you can see that you are going towards the end of life. But you can say clearly by your own mouth that, let's be sincere, this is not a sweet ending. Things are not sweeter. Things are not better. Something went wrong in the beginning. Ikan kan sele ni bere ni. Esa, enikan wa rugbo ojo ni o. There is someone called the Ancient of Days. So gba mi sa, ani enikan wa sa, arugbo ojo ni. Sele ni ti mo so yi sa, o le lo si ibere ti wo le lo yen. He can go to your beginning. In fact, that's your ending. That Bible says has to be sweeter than the beginning. He will see the end here. He already can also go into your future and go and make your ending sweet before you get there. He can go to your beginning and do correction that will make the ending to be better than the beginning. I hope somebody is following me this morning. Having said that, what are those 2 things that you need to use so that starting from today, sir? Oh, ni ni ojo kan ta ma pe ni wasted day. You are not going to listen. I'm speaking to you prophetically this morning. After this broadcast, I want to believe God is going to raise men and women that we journey in life, but we not have wasted years anymore. You will have wasted days anymore. You will not have wasted months. You will not have wasted anything starting from this day. But you need to have these two keys. Ikemeji, to shape pataki. Two things that are important. Do you know why I'm bringing this to you? Year 2020 is coming to an end in a few days. And you will, there's going to be another beginning. Another beginning of year 2021. Meanwhile, that year 2021, we also have an ending. So that the beginning and the ending can be the best for you. I want you to align your life this morning. That is why I'm bringing these two things to you. Let's quickly look at those two things so that we can praise God again, if possible, dance, and then we pray together. And that will be it this morning on Church Online. Somebody sent me a text just now on my WhatsApp saying that this thing is not functioning well on YouTube and on my personal page. That's why I said, whenever we are on live broadcast like this, do not go to my personal page. The broadcast is also on my personal page. It's on YouTube, but it's on all the social medias. But always come directly to the ministry's page. That's Gore's page, Gospel Response Ministry. When you are on this page, you won't have a hitch or any breakage in transmission. Hallelujah. Let's look at those two things. Number one is in the book of that same Psalm that we read this morning. Psalm 92, and we're going to read only verse 13. Psalm 92. Let's have it on the screen. Psalm 92. Admin, put it on the screen. Or anybody there. Psalm 92 and verse 13. Oh my goodness. I'm so excited this morning. Because I discovered why many people will spend 50 years on earth and 35 years will be wasted. Some have spent 50 years. And do you know what is that? The whole 50 has actually been wasted. The only time they think it's not wasted, they were not active, is the first to 5 years on earth when they were toddlers. Or maybe first to 10 years when they were toddlers, just baby, you know, just a boy or a girl, a small, a little child. The rest years, when they have become so conscious of life and they've actually started the journey by themselves, has been wasted years, wasted months, wasted days. Some people, they have wasted 24 hours a day and somebody will waste 20 hours out of it. Some will have 24 hours wasted. But having come in contact with this broadcast this morning, I tell you the truth, you will no longer have wasted years. You will no longer have wasted months. And what I'm saying is not just because of the word of God. I'm also saying it prophetically. By apostolic unction, I pronounce upon you, you will no longer have wasted years. You will no longer have wasted months. You will no longer have wasted days. Your years will yield increase. Your years will yield fruits for you and good fruits in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Psalm 92, verse 13. We're going to read Psalm 92, verse 13. Let's look at that scripture very well this morning. Verse 13. Those that be planted in the house of our God, they shall flourish in the courts of the Almighty God. I want that be seen with Leonua, Kalibaya Baba. One shade, one guru, one dinla. Ah, and you come on, Corica. Honey, bear me so, bear me the day. Family was okay. So, me dear, Nila Baba, oh, go, I am you. Jeko yoja de familo was okay, mama Jeko. Bobby Laroy, I want to hear me this morning. Psalm 92, verse 13. Those, only those that are planted in the house of our God. Jackie Sari said clarification come back here. Let me clear something there. When the scripture says those who are planted in the house of our God, because I know the first thing that will come to somebody's mind is, oh, thank God, I'm planted in Methodist Church. Thank God, I'm planted in Redeem. Thank God, I'm planted in Neighborland. Thank God, I'm planted in Kerubu. Thank God, I'm planted in CSC. Thank God, I'm planted in Celestia. Thank God, I'm planted in Winners. Thank God, I'm planted in Rema. Thank God, I'm planted in Clerical Churches. Where my dad will come for me. Hallelujah. That is not what God is saying here. No, sir. Those who are planted in the kingdom, I want to have me seen in Joba Loru. The kingdom is his house. The kingdom is his tabernacle. Those who are planted in the presence of Almighty God, El Shaddai, Elohim, the Bible says they will flourish. One dinla, one sherere, they will flourish. One boru, they will, their coast will be enlarged. Can I say something to you, sir? If I were you, can I say shenio, toba say shenimo so, ma me shokwe, 2021 will day. Unless that bag be missile alorun eo kariba sunda ye katalia mo fe ke yan kan gbo mi gada laro isa mo fi fi ami royal apostolic ati awon woli gba adura laro yi. I pray by the ocean of the apostolic calling and the prophetic ministry, everyone that will take a decision to be planted in God, and by this encounter I decree, henceforth, you will no longer have wasted years. You will no longer have wasted months. You will flourish. Your coast will be enlarged. Bamisa, if you are not planted in the house of the Lord, in the beginning, excuse me, sir, you have jeopardized the ending. Oh, Gbesile Olorun ni bere. O ti ba igbeje. Because Isaiah 46 says, God determines the ending from the beginning. If you are not yet planted in the courts of Jehovah, in the tabernacle of El Shaddai, you are risking and jeopardizing the journey of life. That is the first thing. And I want to encourage as many as possible. Hey, and listen. I'm not talking about church this time around. A lot of people are in church and they are not in the kingdom. A lot of people are in church and they are not planted in the house of God. They are not planted in the courts of Jehovah. They are not planted in the courts of El Shaddai. No, sir. God do not know them. They don't know God. Bible we pe mo mo awon temi, awon temi si mami. Si Olorun mo eh. If you go into year 2021, today is the last Sunday in 2020. 2021 is just 5 or 6 days ahead. If you enter into that year without planting yourself, spirit, soul, and body in the tabernacle of God, sir, you are already determining the ending of year 2021 for your life, for your family, for your business, and for everything you are going to do on earth. I want that to sink. Get planted in the house of God. Get committed to the kingdom. By that, sir, you are securing your life and the life of everyone around you. Your family, your business, your household. You are securing destiny. You are telling the one that is called the Alpha and Omega. You are telling him, I'm set for a beautiful ending. I am set for a beautiful beginning. Why? I'm planting my spirit, soul, and body in the courts of our God. Let's go to the second thing, because I want us to pray. We really need to pray. We are ending the year, so we're going to praise and worship God. We are going to rejoice, and then we will pray. So let's go to the second one. I've given you one. Becoming planted. Become planted, spirit, soul, and body, in the courts of our God. What is the second thing? Let me tell you before we read it. Excuse me, sir. Now, let's read it before I tell you. First Corinthians, very popular scripture, but that has been lost in the process of time. Men and women, churches don't even read this anymore, and I will tell you why this morning. First Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 9. In churches, sometimes when they want to read it, they even skip it. This morning, I will tell you why. You'll be shocked why we don't read this scripture anymore. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9. 1 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 9. Let's look at the second thing. Hear it clearly. Know ye not. Share your money. Know ye not. Share your money. People, Esa, we know. But we live in denial. Our leadership in the church, they are aware of this, but they live in denial. Our bishops, our reverends, our prophets, our general overseers, they are all aware of this thing. They know. Do you know one thing? You too, you know. But you consciously throw it away from your soul so that it will appear as if you don't know. So that it will appear as if I don't know. The Bible says, know ye not that the righteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Say eyin ko mo pe awon alaiso to ki yo jogun ijoba Olorun. Let me take a minute on this. We are still going to read it. We're going to read it actually to verse 10. But let me explain this first sentence in verse 9. No, if you look at the tone of that word, this is an aggressive word. This oroi, what if anything who belongs to oroi, daddy? To pass oroi, omi pe ka ho kankan ti shele. To pa, she kan she, sebe, ebe so kwe omo. Just like a mother telling her daughter, be precious, ofe so kwe omo, kwe ko oye ko fabo. Olu, ofe so kwe omo, kwe ko gbale. You want to say you don't know you are supposed to wash plate? You want to tell me you woke up in the morning, you don't know that you are supposed to go and brush your mouth, brush your teeth, and get on your hygiene, take your bath, and wash your body. And you know, you want to tell me on a Sunday morning that you don't know that when you wake up, you say good morning to dad or mom? That's, you. If you look at it, Ibinuni is not a laughing word. It's not a joking word. Kishi oro ye, kishi awada. The Bible says, know ye not that the unrighteous, do you know one thing? If the unrighteous is your general overseer, is the founder of the church, is the Gio, is daddy Gio or mommy Gio, if that unrighteous is Prophet Omoshehim, if that unrighteous is Sister Bimpe, if that unrighteous is Deacon Francis, if that unrighteous is Oluso Yemi, if that unrighteous is Pastor Banabe, if that unrighteous is Prophet or Bishop or Deacon or Lay Preacher or Reverend or Very Reverend, the Bible says, "See, O my people, so talk a county where job alone. Maori, that's a calendar, yeah. Bamila Roisa, apart from you being planted in the courts of our God, let righteousness, O Tito Ati Ododo, let it become your watchword as you begin the new year 2021. Ni gbogbo nkan to ba se laye, to ba ti le duro si O Tito Ati Ododo. Excuse me, sir. Only ninu ona ipadanu. What I said is this for those who don't understand Yoruba. If everything you do on earth, I'm speaking to you this morning as an apostle of God, as an ambassador in Itafina, God bless you, Oluso Ilere Oluwa Parish. God bless you, sir. Thank you, Ilere Oluwa Parish. God bless you. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9, the unrighteous, do you want to tell me you are in my kingdom? She ever so queer, oh man. Do you want to say you don't know that your pastor, even you yourself, husband, wife, he will righteous, no matter your title? The Bible says, don't tell me, my people, that you don't know that the unrighteous will not inherit my kingdom. I can't design a beautiful beginning for them. I cannot design a wonderful ending for them. And these are two things that cannot meet. In kameji ti o le pade laye, ibere ati opin. Oloje ki so wi pe ojo to wo aye atojo to ma jade laye won le pade. Sugbe nikan to le so ojo mejeji ye papo ni a pe ni aye raye. Hey, the only one that can join the forces of these two things together, the beginning and the ending, to determine your purpose and destiny in life, his name is Ancient of Days. And that Ancient of Days says, don't you know? She ever saw prayer, oh man, that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God. If a pastor is that unrighteous, he's a pastor. The congregation knows him to be a pastor. They call him daddy. They call the wife mommy. Excuse me, sir. They are not going to inherit the kingdom. And heaven cannot design a beautiful beginning for such people or a wonderful ending. I'm speaking to you this morning because I want you to align your life so much that 2021 will not be a wasted year. 2022, if Jesus tarries, 2023, and so on and so forth. If Jesus tarries to come, you must not have a wasted year again on earth. But Bobby Dadasa, you will have a wasted year if you are unrighteous. Because God, who determines that beautiful beginning and glorious ending, says, the unrighteous, Elisha Oto, at Elisha Ododo. Emilio Olusuaguto, to dúró swaju congregation, to gbe microphone, o pairo de mo pe o pairo. Oludasile Josin ni, mo ri general overseer, to pairo tori idamewa ati offering. Mo ri woli, to pairo tori owo to fe gba lati je lati mu. Excuse me, sir. No matter how high you place anybody, if they are unrighteous, they are not part of the kingdom. They might have been your pastor for 30 years, your prophet. They might have been your GO. Even you might have been in that congregation for 10 years. You might think you are planted. You are righteous, you are not part of the kingdom. Oh, Shiolo Oto, oh, Shiomo Ijoba Olorun. Oh, Shiolo Dodo, oh, Shiomo Ijoba Olorun. E je ki kawe yesi sale die, kale rande o. So that we can pray, we can dance, and we can enjoy the Sunday, the last Sunday of the year. Know ye, listen to it again. Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived. Ego, o teni e ma je tan yi wo, e ba tan ara yin mi o ni tan yin. If you like, you want to deceive yourself, I'm not going to deceive you. Be not deceived. Don't be deceived. Neither fornication, fornicators, idolaters, adulterers, effeminate, abusers of themselves. I want to buy a one jet. You abuse yourself with drugs, with alcohol, with cocaine. You abuse yourself with creations of humanity. In contact your way, you know, of your abuse, is my life. You abuse yourself with immorality. 14, 15, 16 year old girls and boys messing around under European laws that parents can't control. You are destroying yourselves. No beautiful beginning, and there cannot be a wonderful ending. A pecani monsha dura ni move balaroy. I want to rejoice with you for a beautiful beginning and for a wonderful ending. The Bible says, all these people, the unrighteous, the fornicators, the fornicators, idolaters, adulterers, effeminate, abusers of themselves with mankind. I want to buy you. I want you. I want you one free okunrin. I love the Yoruba. Only I want you one free okunrin. But I want you. Yo, that's Yoruba version. Covetous, drunkards, revelers. Oh, I got love rev. Let's paint the town red. Revelers, extortioners, alone lower gba. I want to know what Mary, whether pastor, prophet, deacon, deaconesses, politicians, no matter the category they may belong. I want to know what Mary, all these people only shall not inherit the kingdom of God. And because they are not members of this kingdom, because they are not going to inherit this kingdom, there will not be a beautiful beginning for them, and there will not be a glorious ending. And Ecclesiastes 7:8 says, better is the ending of a matter than the beginning. Isaiah 46:10 says, God declares. He's the only one that can declare that end from the beginning. Do you know what I have brought to you this morning, brothers and sisters? I want 2021 to be very glorious. I want it to be very sweet. I want it to be better. As a matter of fact, I want 2021 to be exceptional. And if Jesus tarries to come, I want all the years ahead of me, all the years ahead of you, to be very, very beautiful. And do you know one thing? The remaining days in year 2020, God can still do wonders. And I want him to do those wonders in your life. Shall we pray together this morning? Before I pray for you, or before I ask you to pray, if you have heard this word and you are pricked in your heart, this thing strike your soul. Oh, Babi Kalara, Tofi Mwepe, Kilo Shemi Gana, and you want to come to righteousness. Jesus is our righteousness. You want to surrender your life to Jesus. It's an opportunity. Say the sinner's prayer. Tell him, I'm sorry for my sins. Come into my life and become my Lord and Savior. Come and reign in me. Confess him as Lord and Savior with your mouth. Do you know one thing? That is very simple. Because he already did the job. And you are welcome to the kingdom. You are welcome to the kingdom. You are welcome into righteousness. And I tell you the truth, a beautiful beginning is designed for you now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Let somebody begin. Go ahead and begin to thank God. I've heard God. We're going to pray two prayer points. So quickly, go ahead and begin to appreciate God. Say, Lord, I thank you. Man, we are all Ruga. Oh, yeah, but sinning. But my own. So I just go to the journey. Only Joe. Toba the best soldier in the only fellow song. Oh, won't be more shame sorrow. Oh, won't be more shame shame. God never considered it. Say, Lord, I thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
Are you ready now? Are you ready now?
Oh, in your Lord, you owe the dumb on job, Lord. So praise him, worship him. Say, God, I thank you. I'm grateful to you. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, my God. Blessed be your name. I'm grateful to you. I worship you for this year 2020. Thank you, Jesus. My Savior. My King. Baba faye mi da bira, Baba faye mi da bira, oh. I'm so excited. God is good. In Jesus' mighty name, you have worship. And if it's dancing, in Jesus' name, you have danced. You know what I want you to do now? I want you to pray. And only two prayers I want you to lift up to God. Say, Daddy, you said that the ending will be better than the beginning. As year 2020 is rolling to an end, let it be sweeter. Let it be more glorious. Let it be more wonderful. Every outstanding miracles, benefits of heaven that I've not received, Daddy, let it be delivered to me. Esa, mo be ko fi gbagbo gbadu alaro itori ko wa ninu eto yi. Gbogbo awon benefit to ti wa crew ti coronavirus ti won se lockdown ti won je ki raye jade lo gba. Tori lockdown ti won ti e mole fun month. You were locked down for months. You were stranded. Say, Daddy, you are a miraculous working God. Miracle working God. Let those benefits be delivered to me. Make the end of this year very beautiful, very sweet, very glorious for me and my household. So, dear, go ahead, Lord Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. In the name of Jesus, I told you. Oh, God, go ahead, Lord. odun ipari lo gbogbo kan to je to mi ti mi o raye gba nitori ajakale arun to sele abi tori ogun aye to dide oluwa rushe si mi send them to me every good things every benefits outstanding blessings mareke teli gayaba release them to me oluwa release won for me by apostolic caution this morning bo se gbagba emi no gbagba fun e mo fi mi aroyan woli ati awon apostle mo fi so aso tele gbogbo ebuku orun e olorun ko yan da fun e let heaven release it to you let heaven release them to you in the name of Jesus father release them to me every outstanding blessing father let it come out gbogbo ikona re orun da pada gbogbo ikona re olorun da pada atomi tun da pada ayeraye da pada gbogbo ikona re olorun da pada in the name of Jesus gbogbo ikona re se mo ni olorun da pada in the name of Jesus orun da pada orun da pada so shall it be thank you father in Jesus mighty mighty name we pray come sir eyo kan lokun ma le gbadura fun e tori akoko ti lo time has gone only one more I want to ask God listen don't forget that scripture the Bible says Isaiah 46 verse 10 God declares the end from the beginning olorun lo ma se ipinu ipari o de ma se ipinu e lati ibere be olorun laaro yin oluwa nitori e counter ti mo ni lori eto yi mo be yin determine the best of life for me se ipinu nkan to da ju laye ati lorun fun mi starting from now even as I begin 2021 father let my life be sweet let it be glorious don't allow my journey to amount to failure adua ni oruko jesu o soro I want to pray don't let my life be amount to let my life amount to failure starting from the beginning oluwa fi agbara re laye mi starting from the beginning show your power show your might determine the best for me the best that heaven and earth can offer let me have it oh God let me have it let me have it eto daju ti orun ati aye to le fi fun eniyan oluwa fi sinu irajo mi fi sinu ise iranse mi fi sinu ori awon ebi mi omo mi iyawo mi gbogbo ti ba dawole let go your sirere lord let my life amount to success thank you my father blessed be your holy name glory to God glory be to Jesus thank you father blessed be your holy name oh thank you Jesus in Jesus mighty mighty name we have prayed listen to me very well this morning I want to tell God finally I always say to people that is a blessing for Sunday ibuku ojo isimi the Bible says and God blessed the seventh day God blessed the seventh day which is Sunday ojo isimi father the blessing of today let it come unto me let me have access to it je ki ojo ni ko wa ye mi wa o ya ma ba lorun soro be I want to pray for you I want to talk to God father bless my life bless me and let the blessing show for oluwa buku fun mi je ki buku na ko si han si gbangba oluwa buku fun mi bless me let your blessing show forth in my life bless me and let your blessing show forth in my life father bless me the blessings of the seventh day the bible says and God blessed the seventh day only olorun buku ojo keje ibuku ojo keje the blessings of the seventh day let it come upon my life thank you father in Jesus mighty mighty name we pray and so I bless you this morning in the name of Jesus I declare prophetically and apostolically henceforth As you enter into 2021, you will not have wasted years. You will not have wasted effort. You will not have wasted time. Only a conquer is share conditional. Lord God Jesus, Ogoreyo Fujade. The blessings of today will go with you to the new year. It will be a permanent blessing in the mighty name of Jesus. I bless your household. I bless your business. I bless your health. I bless your family. You are blessed. I declare you blessed in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty, mighty name. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. That's it for tonight. For this morning on Church Online. I will see you again on Thursday, 5 p.m. UK time. Thursday happens to be the first day in year 2021. And it's the day of our broadcast. So join me on Thursday, 5 p.m. UK time. All right? You can enjoy the music. You can dance, you can pray, you can worship God. Ole ni Olorun, ole gbadura, ole dupe, ole so pe ami. God bless you, Rigu. I'm your friend, your brother. Kunle Omoshe is my name. God bless you. Woo! Glory to God. I thank God because it's not everybody that got God's message. I thank God. Thank God for your life. God bless you. I appreciate you. I thank God for your life. Please don't forget 5 p.m. UK time next week, Thursday, 1st of January 2020. I will bring the word of God to you and the mind of God for the year 2021. Till then, keep riding in God's glory. Keep riding in God's blessings, and the Lord of heaven will bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Amen. Bye for now.